Hello everyone. In this video lecture, let us continue understanding module 3, gate level modeling. In this lecture, let us understand the buffer NOT gates in Verilog. The buffer NOT gates in Verilog can have one scalar input, but they can have multiple outputs. They can have one or more outputs. So this is in contradiction to the AND OR gates, which can have one output but multiple inputs. The buffer NOT gates can have one scalar input and one or more scalar outputs. So in the gate instantiation, the last terminal will be the input, all other terminals will be the output. This we can understand when we see the gate instantiation of the buffer and the NOT gates. So the last terminal in the list is the input, the other terminals are the output terminals. So the two basic buffer NOT gate primitives provided in Verilog are the buff representing the buffer and the NOT representing the NOT gate. The symbols for these gates are, this is a symbol of a buffer, which is a simple triangular symbol with a single input and a single output. This represents the symbol of a NOT gate with a single input, single output, a bubble at the output of the buffer. So in Verilog, these gates are instantiated or invoked as follows, in the same way we did the AND OR primitives. So we are going to write the name of the primitive, which is buff, give an instance name which is optional. So buff P1 is the instance name we are giving, and the order is the list, the last list in the list, the last variable is the input, all others are the output. So we can check here, we have output comma input list. Similarly, NOT N1 output comma input list. So in case the buffer has multiple outputs, so buff B2 is the instance name. We have listed all the outputs first, but the last variable is always the input because it has a single input. Similarly for the NOT gate. Now let us look into the truth tables for the buffer and NOT gates. So this is the truth table for a buffer with a single input and a single output. From the value set, we have understood that input can be 0, 1, x and z. These are the four value set supported in Verilog. So a buffer just transfers the input value to the output. So if the input is 0, we get the output as 0. If the input is 1, the output is a 1. But if the input is x and high impedance state, that is unknown and high impedance state, the output will be a unknown condition itself. Now let us see the truth table of a NOT gate with a single input and a single output. So the value set we are providing for the input is 0, 1, x, z. We know that the NOT gate complements the input applied. So if the input is 0, the output is a 1. If the input is 1, the output is a 0. For the rest of the two conditions where the input is an unknown and a high impedance state, the output will be unknown itself. So these are the truth tables of the buffer and the NOT gates. We have one more class of gates under the buffer and the NOT gates, known as the buffif and the notif gates. So these are the gates with an additional control signal on the buffer and the NOT gates. So these gates will propagate, or these gates function only if their control signal is enabled. So if the control signal is enabled, the buffer or the NOT gate is enabled and it functions in the normal way. Otherwise, in case it is not enabled, if the control signal is disabled, the buffer or the NOT gate is also disabled. In such case, we are going to get the output as a high impedance state. So the gate primitives for these buffif and notif gates in Verilog are the buffif 1 and the buffif 0, the notif 1 and the notif 0. So these are the four primitives, gate primitives for the buffif notif gates, that is gates with the control signal. Let us look into the symbols of the buffif notif gates. So we have totally four gates. So we have the buffif 1. Buffif 1 means it works like a buffer if the control signal is 1. So this is an active high control signal. If the control signal is 1, this buffer functions in the normal way. So we can see the additional input provided in the buffer symbol, that is a buffif 1. Similarly, we have a NOTIF 1, which is a normal NOT gate to which we attach one control signal. This gate functions like a NOT gate if the control signal is 1, NOTIF 1. Similarly, we have BUFF 0, which means it's a buffer with a control signal which is active low, and this buffer functions only if the control signal is zero. So that is highlighted by putting a bubble. So only if the control signal is zero, this buffer functions, else it does not function. Similarly, we have the not if zero. Not if zero functions if the control line is zero, it functions like a not gate. So these are the four symbols of the buffif and the not if gates. Let us look into the truth table of the buffif one. So this is a symbol of a buffif one. So buffer if control signal is one. So this is a truth table where these set of inputs represent the control signal and these set of values represent the input signal. Now, what do we know? If the control signal is zero, this is an active high buffer if one. So if the control is one, it functions like a buffer. Otherwise, you're going to get a high impedance state. So in the first column, we have the control signal as zero. So we are going to get a high impedance state for all the cases because the buffer is disabled. In the second condition, we have control signal as one. If the control signal is one, it means that the buffer is enabled. If the buffer is enabled, it functions like a normal buffer. What is the input here? Zero. So the expected output is a zero. Input is one, we are going to get a one. For the rest of the two cases where the input is unknown and high impedance state, we are going to get unknown for both the conditions. Now, if the control signal is an X, unknown, we know that unknown can be either logic 0 or logic 1. If unknown is logic 0, then the expected output here is high impedance state, Z. If this X is a 1, then the buffer is enabled, so we are going to get a 0. So the two possible outputs here is either a logic 0 or a high impedance state. A logic 0 or a high impedance state in Verilog is represented by the symbol L. Similarly, for the next case, we may get the output as a logic 1 or a high impedance state. So for such a case, we represent symbol H indicating either logic 1 or a high impedance state. For the rest of the two cases where the input itself is an unknown and high impedance, we are going to get both the cases as unknown. Similarly, for high impedance state, so if the control signal is under the high impedance state, we will get either high impedance state as the output or logic 0. So we are representing it by symbol L. Similarly, for the second case, we are representing it by a symbol H indicating either logic 1 or high impedance. For the rest of the two cases, we are going to get an unknown condition. This is the truth table of a buffif 1. So L symbol means output can be either 0 or Z value. H symbol means the output can be logic 1 or Z value. Let us see the truth table of a buffif 0. So this is the symbol of a buffif 0. We know that buffif 0 means it functions like a buffer if the control signal is 0. So this is an active low control signal. The buffer is enabled when the control signal is 0. The buffer is disabled if the control signal is 1. Let us look into the truth table now. So in this case, it functions like a normal buffer when the control signal is 0. So here we are going to get the normal buffer truth table. So for 0, we are going to get a 0. For 1, we are going to get a 1. For X and Z, we are going to get an unknown condition. Similarly, when we come here, the control signal is 1. So this buffer does not function if the control signal is 1. It is disabled and the output of such a case is a high impedance state. So the entire column here would be a high impedance state because the control signal is 1. When the control signal is X and the control signal is Z, for the first two conditions, it behaves in the similar way where we get an L indicating we may get the output either as logic 0 or high impedance state, and we get a H where the output can be logic 1 or high impedance state. For the rest of the two cases, we are going to get unknown conditions. Similarly, when the control signal is Z, we may get L or a H and unknown conditions for the inputs X and Z. So L represents 0 or Z, H represents logic 1 or Z value. Now let us look into the not if 1 truth table. So this is the symbol of a not if gate. So this not gate functions if the control signal is 1. So this is the truth table. So if the control signal is 0, obviously the NOT gate is disabled. So for this column in the truth table, we are going to get a high impedance state, because if the control signal is 0, the NOT gate is disabled, and the output of a disabled control signal is a high impedance state. If the control signal is 1, this NOT gate functions like a normal NOT gate, so it complements whatever input we have applied. So for 0, we get a 1, for 1, we get a 0, for X and Z, that's unknown and high impedance, we are going to get unknown value itself. Similarly, when the control signal here is X, if the X is 0, we are going to get a high impedance state. If the X is a 1, it works like a NOT gate, so we will get complement of 0, that is 1. So this output can be either logic 1 or high impedance state, which is represented as an H in the truth table. Similarly, this is the complement of 1, which can be either 0 or high impedance state, represented by the symbol L. For the rest of the two cases where the input itself is unknown and high impedance, we are going to get unknown values. Similarly, for control signal equal to Z or high impedance, we will get the same behavior of the unknown control signal. So L means 0 or Z, where H means 1 or Z. Now let us look into the last truth table, that is the NOT if 0. This is a symbol of a NOT if 0 with a control signal equal to 0. This NOT gate functions. So it works like a NOT gate if the control signal is 0, otherwise it doesn't function. It gives us a high impedance output. So let's begin. So here the control signal is 0, it means the NOT gate is active. So here it behaves like a NOT gate, where we get the complementary values. For 0 we get 1, for 1 we get a 0. For the rest of the two cases, X and high impedance, we are going to get unknown. Now if the control signal is 1, we know that this NOT gate is disabled. For a disabled NOT gate, we have to get a high impedance state as the output. In the third column, when we have the control signal as X and Z, the behavior is similar to NOT if 1, wherein if it is X, we may get either a high H case or a L case, where because it's the complement. For 0 we get logic 1, for 1 we get logic 0, or we may get a high impedance state. For unknown and high impedance state inputs, we are definitely going to get X. Similar behavior is observed for the high impedance state value of the control signal, where L indicates either a 0 or Z, and H indicates either a 1 or Z. So how do we do the gate instantiations of these buffif and notif gates in Verilog? So to instantiate the buffif gates, we have to have buffif 1 followed by the instance name, followed by out, because we have to list it as output comma inputs. So we have out, we mention the list of inputs we have. So we have input and the control signal. Similarly, for instantiate buffif 0, you have to write the name as buffif 0, give a name, and then the first list must, in the list, the first variable must be the output. The rest can be the input. So first you can mention the input and the control signal. Similarly, for the instantiation of the NOT if gates, first we have the NOT if 0, which is output, comma in, comma control, and the second one is the NOT if 1, which is out, comma in, comma control. So we just saw that we just have to list the output variable input followed by the control signal as the additional input. So in this video lecture, we understood about the buffer NOT gates in Verilog, the class of gates buffif and NOTIF gates. We saw their symbol and the truth table. Thank you.